In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Glory be to Jesus Christ. My dear friends, today we will read and explain Paul's second letter to Timothy. If you remember Timothy, it means the one who is glorifying God in Greek language. Paul's second letter to Timothy consists largely of personal advice to Timothy as a younger colleague and assistant. The main theme is endurance. Timothy is advised and encouraged to keep on witnessing faithfully to Jesus Christ, to hold to the true teaching of the good news and the Old Testament, and to do his duty as teacher and evangelist, all in the face of suffering and opposition. Timothy is especially warned about the dangers of becoming involved in foolish and ignorant arguments that not good but only ruin the people who listen to them. In all this, Timothy is reminded of the example of the writer's own life and purpose. His faith, patience, love, endurance, and suffering in persecutions. Now, first chapter. From Paul, an apostle of Christ Jesus by God's will. Again, Apostle Paul, he is emphasizing that by God's will he became a believer in Yeshua Mashiach, in his resurrection. He became an instrument of the gospel, instrument of the good news of Yeshua Mashiach. As I told you already, these two words, Yeshua Mashiach, Jesus is Christ, Savior is Anointed One, they inscribe all the topic, the theme of the New Testament. This is what we believe. Old Testament, that Elohim Adonai, that God is Lord. In New Testament, he sent his only begotten Son, Yeshua Mashiach. He died instead of us. He resurrected on the third day. He descended into Hades on Good Friday. Resurrected on the third day. He descended into Hades to proclaim the good news for those people who believed in him. How did they believe? How did they know? They knew what was written in Torah and in the prophecies and in the Psalms. And they believed. They were certain that God promised and he will fulfill that. And God's fulfillment is Yeshua Mashiach, Jesus Christ. And they believed that he was not punished. Jesus told to Apostle Paul, he was not punished. He died willingly to fulfill the will of his heavenly Father, to save us, to proclaim good news, and to bring us back to heaven, to his heavenly Father. Therefore, our faith is that the only way to God the Father is through God's love, through God's revelation, through Yeshua Mashiach, through Jesus, who is Christ. And by his will, Apostle Paul is always emphasizing that he became an apostle, sent to proclaim the promised life which we have in union with Christ Jesus. With Christ Jesus we have spiritual life. With Christ Jesus we are delivered from the death of our soul. To Timothy, my dear son, may God the Father and Christ Jesus our Lord give you grace, mercy, and peace. I give thanks to God, whom I serve with a clear conscience, as my ancestors did. Who were ancestors of Apostle Paul? They were Pharisees. But Pharisees, it means they are separated from the sin. And real Pharisee, he is a friend of Jesus Christ, because he's supposed to recognize in Yeshua Mashiach, in Jesus, Anointed One, Christ, I thank him as I remember you always in my prayers, night and day. Remember your tears, and I want to see you very much so that I may be filled with joy. Spiritual joy, it is like to see the people, you love them, you see that they are following the good teaching and they are evangelism there, going and preaching the gospel about resurrection. It's interesting with joy, and this is, it's very nice to admire the spelling of joy, J-O-Y. It's like if you will like put the meaning of each letter, it might be Jesus, others, and you. If we're living our life like according to these rules, Jesus number one in my life, others number two, and you or me number three, we will reach really holy life. This is what's happened with Apostle Paul and Timothy. But you, like Y-O-J, you others and Jesus, if you read these words, abbreviation from right to left, like you, if I'm first in my life, and then others, and then Jesus, you know, I might not be resistant and persevered in my life. I might lose my faith. And this has happened to some people. Apostle Paul, he will say with regret that some people saw that he was enslaved, they left him. But not Timothy. Timothy, Jesus is first in his life, then others, and then only his life. And his health even. That's why Apostle Paul, in first letter, he said to him, take care of your health. He said to him, drink a little bit of wine, like mixed it with water. It's like a remedy at that time. I remember the sincere faith you have, the kind of faith that your grandmother Lois and your mother Eunice also had. You know, from these words we see that Apostle Paul used to know grandmother and mother of Timothy. His father was Greek, but his mother, grandmother, they came from Judaism. Maybe they were Pharisees, their family also. And what's happened that Apostle Paul, like he's giving him good teaching. And he did heretonia. He gave him the Holy Spirit through the prayers to Timothy to become a bishop, and he wants him to follow Jesus Christ, to pray, not to have fear, and Jesus will help you, him. And Timothy, as we see, he is like a second generation of believers, because he's still young, very young. He became a bishop, Apostle Paul. He wants him to become a bishop because, as we will see very soon, Apostle Paul, he says, maybe I might not see you anymore, but still we are with Jesus Christ. I'm sure that you have it also, the faith he's talking, as his grandmother and mother. For this reason, I remind you to keep alive the gift that God gave you when I laid my hands on you. He's talking about heretonia, laying the hands, anointing. This is like a visible symbol how invisible grace of God is abiding on the candidate. For the Spirit that God has given us does not make us timid. Instead, His Spirit fills us with power, love, and self-control. Do not be ashamed, then, of witnessing for our Lord. Neither be ashamed of me, a prisoner for Christ's sake. Therefore, we see that Apostle Paul, he is a prisoner for Christ's sake. He believes in him. He cannot imagine another kind of life. He said, if I am on this side in previous letters or on the other side, doesn't matter. I just want to be with Christ. Instead, take your part in suffering for the good news, as God gives you the strength for it. Like all the strength, we cannot be enough. We have to have desire to serve God. but the strength when we are desiring, when we love Him, strength comes from God. He saved us and called us to be His own people, not because of what we have done, like not according to the Moses law. Law just showed to the people what is wrong and that the wages of the sin is death. Animals were dying instead of people. But because of His own purpose and grace, through Jesus came grace and grace, double grace, like the greatest grace that comes because Jesus conquered death, not only by law, He fulfilled the law, and law like put Him on the cross in the hands of Sadducees and Pharisees and Herodians. That's why fulfilling the law like did not save Jesus, but He willingly in grace descended into Hades, died on the cross, proclaimed the good news, and resurrected. Therefore, the salvation comes through faith in Jesus Christ and good deeds, but not just from good deeds, from fulfilling Torah, but comes through faith and through God's life. He gave us this grace by means of Christ Jesus before the beginning of time. Remember, before man was created, before the creation of the sixth day, it was like advice, like counsel somewhere, where in Holy Trinity, let us create man. Why let us? Who was talking to whom? That was among God the Father, the Son, and Holy Spirit. Let us create man. Why? And not Elohim, but Adonai, Lord, created man. Because we will have to save him when he will fall into sin. The sin, it's in not in multiple, but in singular, because the sin of unbelief makes us to be a sinner in everything. If we believe in God, we will keep everything. If we don't believe in Him, we will try to do something and not to do something. Therefore, before the time that decision had been made, before the beginning of time that God will become Lord, He is Lord. God is Lord. Like Elohim is Adonai. This is like all topic and fulfillment of the Old Testament. And New Testament, Yeshua Mashiach, Jesus, He is anointed one, His Messiah. But now, it has been revealed to us through the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Therefore, that was the decision before the creation of the time, but revealed to us by the power of death and resurrection of Jesus Christ, Savior Jesus Christ. He has ended the power of death and through the gospel has revealed immortal life. The gospel, what is it? The good news that law cannot make us free from the sin, but Jesus, our faith in Him, His death made us free already. But we have to believe in that and to do everything because we love Him and believe Him. God has appointed me as an apostle and teacher to proclaim the good news. And it is for this reason that I suffer these things. For this reason, because Christ appeared to him. Because he understood that God loves him. He loves every sinner, but he wants every sinner to repent, to change his life and to follow him. And this has happened with Shaul, Rabbi. We read this in chapter 9 of the Acts of the Apostles. But I am still full of confidence because I know whom I have trusted. And I am sure that he is able to keep safe until that day what he has entrusted to me. God is keeping us safe when we are following him. Hold firmly to the true words that I taught you as the example for you to follow, and remain in the faith and love that are ours in union with Jesus Christ. Faith and love, we cannot love without Jesus Christ. Because Jesus, we have to find out how he loves us. His love to us brought him to Good Friday and to death on the cross, but also to the resurrection, ascension into heaven. And he is sharing the Holy Spirit. He is sending the Holy Spirit who will empower his bride, earthly church. And we are among those supposed to be. Through the power of the Holy Spirit who lives in us, keep the good things that have been entrusted to you. You know that everything in the province of Asia, including Phygelus and Hermogenes, has deserted me. Like everyone, not everything, everyone. Apostle Paul, he is regret, he was jail, and many people, they were afraid what's going to happen to their businesses and to their future. They were not firm in faith. They deserted, they left him. May the Lord show mercy to the family of Onesiphorus, because he cheered me up many times. Apostle Paul is praying for him particularly. He was not ashamed that I am in prison, but as soon as he arrived in Rome, he started looking for me until he found me. May the Lord grant him his mercy on that day. What day? On that special day when we will have to stand before the judgment seat of Jesus Christ. And all our life is supposed to be like ready for that day. And all Jesus' life since his incarnation was striving to the Good Friday. He always remembered what has to happen. And we have to think about this special day. Only Lord's mercy will save us when we will believe in him and follow him in our life. And you know very well how much he did for me in Ephesus. Like we see, Apostle Paul, he knows how to be grateful. He is praying for those people. He is praying for everyone who will come to Jesus Christ. And Jesus, he was praying for everyone. And this is so important to know until Christ's second coming. Like we are the church who is fighting with the sin. But not by our own power only, no. But God helps us. Through our faith, we are receiving his power through the Holy Spirit. Amen. Glory be to Jesus Christ.